Hi, Carl. Sorry to be late.
Danny, they keep me waiting here so long.
Jill, I nearly break my neck to get here.
None of my boyfriends just keep me waiting, you know.
And if it wasn't for Mr. Wells, you wouldn't be anywhere in our office. But I am a man. I have nothing to offer.
What do you mean? I live with Mr. Wells?
That is what you know saying. I didn't say that.
You say you have nothing to offer, which means I have something to offer.
They will quicker take on a woman than a man anytime, and you know that.
Let me tell you, mister. I live here, and Mr. Wells living where he living. I live with nobody yet. Yet, see, I still in my mother's house, and not like a lot of girls who name I could call.
Oh, you mean like Shirley?
That is right. She far worse than me.
Oh, you mean she far worse than you? Because she live with me, she far worse than you?
Listen to me, fella. You see me here, I am moving into no man's house. I remaining right in my mother's house.
Yes, but you went to work for Mrs. Wells and you end up taking away she husband.
He's not the only husband that follow me around after the wife fired me.
So, you specialize in this sort of business?
If a nice and male want me, what do you want me to do?
But even in this sort of thing, you must have some kind of conscience.
Yeah, who talking about conscience? A man lives with a woman 3 times his age.
You just as no good as me.
It's true.
So?
What you feel?
You seem to be a good match.
A good match for what?
To do what you like to do.
What?
I'm talking about making love, Carl.
Oh, I know, really.
Because I really love you, Carl.
You're a little fast moving, though. Cool it.
Let me go up to my room in the alley now.
Wait, take it easy. Don't rush things.
Go on, let's go now, Carl.
Not me, boy. I afraid maybe I go bust my head with a bottle.
That ain't gonna happen. My room is like a little kingdom.
Oh, you like the spider? Would you walk into my palace, set a spider to the fly? But in this case, come up to my room.
Well, I can't say, come into my car like Mr.
Go ahead.
Mr., you well know who I'm.
Feel your jealous demand.
Look, I have what I have. And if you don't like it, we might as well forget one another right now.
Let me hear what you have.
Well, I have a room to start with.
Yes, and you're paying rent for it?
Yes, I'm paying rent. Anything wrong with that? Plenty of people paying rent.
What else you have?
I have all kinds of things in the room. I have a bed, chairs, bureau.
And I'm sure you ain't finished paying for everything.
No.
Come, let me hear what else you have.
Not much else.
So what you offering me?
So you want something?
A woman that's grown with a man for nothing?
Look, I have nothing. Nothing at all.
Alright, don't get huffed. I know you have nothing.
So what you want then?
You?
You can have me anytime, Carl. Right now.
Hold your horses, not here.
Where?
I will tell you. Just take it easy and play it cool.
Alright, if you say so. I'll see you then.
Danny, don't go. Stay and talk to me. After tonight, I will have time until next week.
Stay and talk about what?
Just talk about yourself from the time you're born.
That is a long story.
Come and sit down next to me and tell me the story of your life. And don't censor it.
Am I boring and send you fast asleep?
I'm sure it's more exciting than this. I'll just close my eyes and listen to the sound of your voice.
Well, I was born on the 19th of December. My mother was a washerwoman.
Guess who?
Arthur Wells.
How you know?
You're the only person that's put your hand on my eyes and asked, guess who? But I thought you said you wasn't coming down here for people to suspect.
I had to come to see you. It's 2 days now I ain't kiss you and I feel I'll die.
You won't, Mr. Wells.
Mr. Wells?
Yes. We're in an office, remember?
I want a kiss right now.
You really mad?
Come, sweetheart.
Satisfied? Now go and open the door before somebody come in.
Suppose it better or not at all?
Both of us could lose our jobs for this.
I won't, but you will. What are you doing this evening?
Nothing. What do you have in mind?
I was thinking about a moonlight dip in my arrow. Some of the fellas and girls will be going and we'll have a cook up on the beach. crabs will be running and we'll catch some and cook them too.
That's so exciting. You could count me in Artie. But Artie, I have nothing to wear.
I saw a nice outfit at Sweet and Lovely Boutique that will suit you fine. Hold on to this.
You sure $200 would be enough? You men always forget accessories.
Sorry, my dear. Look, an extra $100.
Thank you. Who will be there?
Well, to tell you the truth, it's really some of the fellas in my age and their deputies.
No swapping, I hope.
No, I will never agree to that.
You old fellas are too terrible. I'm beginning to feel more comfortable with the younger fellas.
You know I'm young in body. You know how much I... Yes, Miss Parker. You must get those papers with the total sales for last month up to my department. Hello, Raphael.
Hi, Arthur. Surprised seeing a man like you in this department.
I had to rush some work for Mr. Goodman, so I thought I'll come myself for information.
Good. It's always nice seeing a man like you. And I am sure Miss Parker is glad to see you too. Miss Parker, could you hand me that blue folder under those books? Yes. Good. Thank you. See you.
Right on, Raphael.
Wow, that was close.
That's why I can't understand with them fellas. They can't see you talk to a woman unless they feel you in something.
He might be so right. He didn't hear the way he say, I'm sure Miss Parker glad to see you too.
You think he suspect me in something?
The way he was looking at us, I feel so. You think he see when you give me the money?
I don't think so. I was standing right here. No, he can't.
What about when you close the door?
Let me see. No, in any case, he can't do anything.
I hope he don't fire me. I can't take on servant work again.
The only good thing about that job is that you always end up with your one husband.
But the salary wasn't big enough, so what you want me to do?
After work, meet me on the last entrance by Shackon Street.
Arthur, remember we're going out this evening and I have to go and buy an outfit.
Oh, I forget that. Right, tonight. I'll see you about 7.
All right, I'll be waiting.